Good morning, Standard 12 students. Hope you all are safe and fine, learning your lessons, watching my video. Students, we are going to start the third chapter from section A. We have already discussed dictatorship, autocracy, and liberal forms of government in chapter 1. We have also discussed about unitary and federal form of government in chapter 2. Today we are going to learn a very interesting and important chapter, that is parliamentary and presidential form of government. On their basis of nature, the relationship between the legislature and the executive, two alternative forms of government stand identified, that is parliamentary form of government and presidential form of government. Today we will learn the meaning, features, merits and demerits of the parliamentary form of government. Let's understand what is parliamentary government. It is named so because it is constituted by those members of the parliament who are in majority. It is also called responsible government because in it the executive, that is the ministers, are individually and collectively responsible for all the acts before the parliament. The parliamentary government is one in which the executive has two parts, nominal executive and real executive. Nominal executive is the head of the state, is the nominal executive, and is responsible and is not responsible, that is the president. And in the real executive, the council of ministers headed by the prime minister is the real executive and for all its acts collectively responsible before the legislature. Let's note the features which is given in page number 57. There are 10 features. Let's go according to the points. First one is the difference between the nominal and the real executive. In a parliamentary government, the executive has two parts, that is the nominal executive and the real executive, which we have already discussed earlier. Now, the second point is close and continuous relationship between the legislature and executive. In the parliamentary form, the executive is very closely related to the legislature. Executive is constituted out of the legislature. Third is ministerial responsibility. In the ministerial responsibility, we have three points wherein they talk about the responsibility of the ministers towards the head of the state, individual responsibility of each minister, and collective responsibility. Then we have non-fixed tenure of the real executive. The Council of Ministers remains in office so long as it enjoys the confidence of the majority in the legislature. It can be removed from office at any time by the legislature by passing a vote of no confidence. Then we have Prime Minister as the head of the government. As the leader of the majority party, the national leader, and as a real executive head, the Prime Minister enjoys the position of preeminence in the parliamentary system. Very strong position of the Prime Minister. The Prime Minister is the real center of power and keystone of the entire system. As the head of the government, he exercises vast and real executive powers. Next we have Prime Minister and the cabinet ministers can get the legislative dissolved. The cabinet and in actual practice the Prime Minister has the right to advise the head of the state in favor of a dissolution of the legislature. Then we have strong position of cabinet, but no such thing as a cabinet dictatorship. Because of the very strong position of the cabinet in a parliamentary system of government, several scholars describe the type of the government as cabinet government. Next, let's understand the merits of the parliament. The merit is harmony between the legislature and executive. In a parliamentary form of government, the executive always works in close harmony with the legislature. It is mostly in the position to get the necessary laws and finances passed by the legislature. Next, we have executive works as a responsible executive. Legislature accepts the leadership role of the Prime Minister and his Council of Ministers. It willingly performs the role of the responsible and accountable executive. Flexibility. Parliamentary government works as a flexible system because a change in the executive can be made without any major difficulty and disturbance. Executive cannot become despotic. The parliamentary executive, because of continuous and alert control of legislature, cannot behave arbitrarily and become despotic. Last point of merit is the public opinion and opposition parties acts as good checks on the government. It continues to work in accordance with the dictates of public opinion and particularly under the critical eye of the opposition. So you have to learn these subheadings. Next we have demerits of the parliamentary government. The first one is the executive dominates the legislature. In the absence of the democratic ethos and sound party system, the parliamentary executive tends to become dictatorial and inefficient. Next week's demerit is executive is weak because its tenure is not fixed. The insecurity of the tenure can also be the source of limitation, particularly when in the legislature, executive enjoys a thin majority. Next, we have executive can act arbitrarily because of committed support of majority party. On the other hand, parliamentary system can also lead to the domination of the legislature by the executive, particularly when it enjoys a majority, big majority of seats in the legislature. Then we have ministers are not appointed on merit. The system of appointing the amateurs and politicians as ministers also involves the risk of giving headships of government departments in the hands of incompetent politicians. Party politics becomes aggressive and dirty. The whole system can get dominated by the excessive and unhealthy partisan politics because between the majority and opposition party. The former can try to dominate the latter and the latter can try to hinder the running of administration by the former. Last demerit is expensive and inefficient system. Besides being an expensive system, it can be a source of instability and inefficiency. In it, a large number of incompetent ministers use the power. So these are the demerits of the parliamentary system. Although there are certain merits and demerits of the parliamentary system of the government, but this type of government, that is the parliamentary form of government, is always better as the cabinet is responsible to the government. Thank you.